keeps solving our physics GRE. So 84 sodium has 11 electrons. Okay, so 11, you need to focus on this 11 because you need to make an electron configuration. Okay, so 11 means that 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, and 3s1. Okay, so this is 11, right? And then what is the general state of sodium usual? Okay. So remember, the s means the angular momentum is zero. Means the angular momentum is zero. And then you have one spin, right? So s is half. And the j is l plus s. So basically it's half. So we have l is zero. So zero means s. Zero means s, and the j is half 2s plus 1, which is 2? Oh, yes. So, nice. The answer is B. Okay. Simple question. You just write down the electron configuration and nothing left. So, 85, the figure above showing the photon interactions cross sections leading to energy range. Oh, difficult. Okay. So basically, if 85 ask, basically it's common sense that when you the pair production give is much difficult to happen because pair production needs a lot of energy. So basically, this is the photon, right? So when photon has a lot of energy, then somehow it will start to have some pair productions, and then when the photon is not so strong, then it will have photoelectric, and the middle is competent, Okay, so this is a difficult problem. So, first we know that the first one, when the energy becomes small, it should be photoelectric. So the first one should be photoelectric. So only A and B are possible. Then what it needs is so 3 should be competent. Two should be pair production, right? Because in a high energy, that pair production will become dominant. So 2 is pair production, 3 is the competent. So the answer is B. Okay, 86 is about Coulomb inverse law, right? Has been found to be to be different from 2 by less than 1 part of billion measure, which of what? Okay. Okay, so the difficult part is we need to find which one is the correct answer. To ask about how to determine the inverse square law has been found to differ by 2 by less than 1 part of billion. Okay, so this problem is difficult. Okay, so let me see. So the first is the charge on oil drop. Definitely wrong, right? Charge on oil drop is can find electron mass. Okay, then B says the deflection of electron being in the electric field. This is the Lorentz force, right? Not due to the Coulomb inversion in inverse square law. Basically, the neutrality of charge. This is probably you want to measure the Q. You want to measure the fundamental charge quantity. So ABC, you have common sense that, oh, it's not correct. And D is the electric force between two charged objects. So D may be possible. Right, common sense, because two charges have the inverse square law. And E looks strange that the electric field inside a charge conducting shell. So E looks quite strange that But remember that. How do we derive that the electric charge inside it's supposed to have a conducting shell. Then how do we know that the middle what is the force in the middle? Since we have the square, if the square inverse law is correct, then this part will cancel this part. So basically, this is a theorem from calculus that you can compute the force between this point in the conducting shell. So basically, if the inverse square law is correct, then basically there will be no force in at any point inside the sphere, because this area will proportional to the distance squared. Okay, so the answer should be E. And to be honest, I didn't get it right at the first time. Basically, because the Gauss law will imply some, will have some implication for this. So remember that Gauss law is correct, basically due to the inverse square. So inverse square law will prove the Gauss law, and the Gauss law will prove this fact. So basically, this fact will reflect the original inverse square law. So 86, the answer is E. Okay, 87. Diatomic molecules, they provide two possible ones. The it's like a rigid object, and the second is the spring. Okay, the model one has specific common sense that you know that the atomic. Okay, so if a monatomic, CV is 3/2R because you have three translations. Okay, so this is a common sense that you need to remember. And CV is 5/2R in the diatomic because you can have two rotation. In general, rigid because you can have this rotation and this rotation, but not this. Okay. And if more not diatomic, then you have 3R because you have three rotations plus three translation. Okay, so the 87, the A is not good. Okay. And the B said the model 2 has a space smaller heat than model 1. So model 2 has more degree of freedom. So it should be have more specific heat. So C and D say, it said that C and D, model 1 and model 2 is always correct. Then why we propose two models, right? So we are not stupid at all, right? So C and D are both impossible. So the answer is E. The choice between model 1 and model 2 depends on temperature. This is okay because at temperature are very high, then there will be an internal degree of freedom. So when temperature high, then the model 2 is okay, and with temperature low, and the model 1 is basically okay. So low temperature model 1, high temperature model 2. Okay, so that's it. So 88. Consider non-interacting particles in the blah 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 blah, and so you have a pressure and a boson and the particle, no quantum effect. Okay, so basically this asks about common sense. So common sense that is that the fermion do not want to hug with each other. So basically fermion is very hard to I don't know how to say, they are not friendly to each other. Okay. Or you want to say more scientific, and they don't want to have sit in the same energy level, and the boson like to hug each other. And the classical effect is just in the middle one. So basically, if you have a lot of fermion, they are not like each other, so they will try to go out. So the pressure of fermion should be large. And the boson like to like each other, so they will try to hug together, so the pressure will be very small. And the middle one is the classical. By the way, if you know the statistical mechanics in press rewarding, you can do the exact calculation. But nobody cares. So the answer is which one? The answer is B. Some more common sense. Okay, so 89 is what? somebody give you a wave function and ask you about which one. Okay, so this is plus, right? So tell you that the phi is S1, S2, says it's equal to phi X2, S1. So this tell you that phi is symmetric. What it means is that phi is boson. So which one is boson? Electron, not boson. Positron, not boson. Proton. Proton is fermion, right? Because if you know about particle physics, then you know there's a thing called quark, and for the protons, or you know that the protons has a half spin. So electron is a fermion. Positron basically is the same as electron. They are also fermion. They are antiparticle to each other, and the proton are also fermion. And what is the neutron? Neutron are also fermions. So which one is the boson? Which one is the boson? The answer is E, right? Deuteron. I already said deuteron has two is the isotope of the hydrogen. So basically, it has one fermion and it has the spin half. Proton and another spin half neutron. So they can form the spin half times plus spin half. So they have one state which is boson. Basically, they have two states because you have two spin half particles. So when you add together, you have spin zero and spin one, which is bosons. So the answer is E. Okay, so I think it's enough for today, and I will see you guys in the next video.